Although the iPhone 7 Plus pretty much has just gotten dropped with support, meaning this thing is not going to be getting any more versions of software, I still think the iPhone 7 Plus is a very, very important iPhone, and I actually still love this iPhone a lot, even though I probably, you know, even though it's in a very interesting situation. So most of us know this by now, the iPhone 7 Plus has gotten dropped with support. It's not going to be getting iOS 16, iOS 17, 18, no more future updates, at least full OS updates, but like many other iPhones Apple has made, even stemming the iPhone 6, 6S, 6S Plus, all those other iPhones, what Apple does typically is that when they go ahead and drop support of an older iPhone, like in this case the 7 Plus, they will still go ahead and support this thing with security updates looking in the future. Now with this specific iPhone, I already have the RCs of iOS 15.6, and the fact that this thing is still getting iOS updates, at least for the time being, is really, really important. Now here's another thing to keep in mind. Looking at the future of this specific iPhone, at least for the next probably a year and a half to 2 years, this iPhone is probably still going to be getting security updates. And just like how we have iOS 15.6 coming out for the iPhone 7, 6S's, and all the way up to the iPhone 13s, most probably when iOS 16 officially goes out, most probably the iPhone 7 Plus is going to be getting, just like with the 6S Plus, security updates specifically tailored for these specific devices. Now, I like the 7 Plus a lot more than the 6S Plus because of not only the design. I mean, when you look at this iPhone, look at how beautiful this iPhone looks. I mean, it is crazy how beautiful a phone like this looks in 2022. This is like a $100 phone, probably even less than that. But this one used to be a flagship, and that's what's so crazy. This is a beautiful looking phone, and I really appreciate the design of this thing. The dual camera setup is still really good. I will say the design of this thing on the front really isn't that great, but I think most of us know this by now. It's definitely not going to be the best looking thing anymore. But when you look at this iPhone, you automatically assume it's not going to be as great or as premium as something like an iPhone 13, and you would be 100% right. But the biggest asset of this phone is the availability and the price tag of it. You can easily buy this thing, and I mean easily buy this thing, for probably less than $100 all day. And even if it was like $110, it's still a pretty decent value. Now, if you plan on keeping a phone for about 2 to 3 years, this is definitely not the one for you. But when I look at this iPhone and I see what it brought to the table, it brought the newer type of design with that dual camera setup. It brought the first iPhone with 3 gigabytes of RAM, and really the performance of this iPhone is still pretty top tier. I play tons of games on this thing, and although some games probably won't be at the best of quality, everything still runs fine, and even games like Genshin Impact that I tested before, even on iOS 15.6, they run very well. You know, these things aren't like super slow performing devices. These things still perform very well, and I'm still a huge fan of this specific iPhone. So when it comes down to it, I think a phone like the 7 Plus sits in a very interesting spot. It's definitely not the best iPhone I would recommend buying, but for the price, it's still pretty decent, and I still love this iPhone for sure. So that kind of covers it up. If you have any other thoughts or questions, let me know in the comment section below. Hit the like button, that would mean so much, but definitely hit that subscribe button. More importantly than everything else, I love every single one of you guys. Hopefully I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace out till then.